just want to start out and hear a little bit about how your firm was handling recruiting before COVID.
In terms of recruiting, we've used a multi-channel approach with the talent shortage that was out there pre-COVID. You basically had to fish wherever you thought the fish were, look in different ponds, and a lot of it was networking. A lot of it was meeting people at chambers of commerce and stuff like that, finding out who was looking for a job. We also did we did the normal websites that you go to find people. We did employee referrals. We basically did anything we could do. Wherever you could find them is where you found them, basically. And I can't say any one channel probably worked any better than any of the other channels.
And so once you did find people, then how are you making sure that your firm was competitive?
I think we know from salary surveys pretty much what we're paying for a person. And our compensation structure, everybody's on a bonus plan based on what they bill, what they contribute to the firm. So to some extent, the salary discussion is a little different for us, because even if somebody feels that we're a little bit low on the salary end with bonus capabilities, they can add 30 to 40% to what they make.
Wow.
So they can pretty much name the number they want and then go get it.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's definitely something you don't see everywhere. So, and with that in place, what kind of, you know, longevity, did you see? Like, how long would people, you know, stay at SNK before you needed to, you know, find somebody else to fill that seat?
Well, we really haven't had any turnover in quite a while on the professional side. I think our shortest tenured person on the professional side at this point is probably 4 years, 5 years. One of the ways we do that is that we incorporate, if somebody wants to go a particular direction, we have no problem adding that as a service line if we think there's some potential there. And we're talking about that now. We talk about it all the time, what's out there that we can do to let people to grow into. I think it's important to have places for people to grow. Otherwise, they leave.
Yeah, well, that's great. And so, you know, some of that being flexible, I'm sure, you know, leads into kind of how you're handling remote work and flexible schedules. Those kinds of things are something I hear about all the time when I'm talking to accounting firms. You know, what did that look like? I know a lot of people are still remote even now, post-COVID, but what did that look like before COVID?
Well, we've been remote capable with Clarity Practice Management and virtual workstations for 7 or 8 years. And the reason behind that remote really had nothing to do with being prepared for a pandemic or anything like that. We've had remote workers for probably 15 to 16 years, maybe longer than that. And as the technology has grown, we wanted a better experience for our remote employees so that they had access to all the same things we had in the office. And what that led us to was an infrastructure that let anybody, in, you know, local or otherwise, who's working for us, work from wherever, whenever. And typically people worked from the office for the most part, but we had the ability, if we had a power outage or an internet outage, we would just all scatter to our houses and we're working. And snow days were another piece of this in Northern Virginia. I'm certain you know what it's like, 1/4 of an inch of snow here and we're shut down for a day. Mm-hmm. So we've always had the ability to do that. Although for the most part, our local employees still worked here. And I've worked a lot of hybrid days pre-pandemic to where I'll work 4 or 5 hours in the office, beat traffic, go home and work a few hours in the late afternoon or evening even during tax season.
Right. And of course, I know from working with you that you're that when it comes to deadlines and everybody else is stressing out, you're typically somewhere fun and exotic.
Yes, I work from the beach pretty much either the September 15th or the October 15th deadline. Every year I pick one of them. This year it was the September 15th deadline. I've worked from the NCAA Final Four 3 times in April. It's nice to have a lifestyle where you can basically do what you want to do, be where you want to be, and still get work done.
Yeah, that sounds great. So then, you know, obviously all this stuff sounds like you're doing pretty good from a recruiting perspective, have some really neat things in place that other workplaces don't. And then COVID hits. So what changes?
For us, we just all scattered, went to our homes and worked just like nothing else. We already had at least 75% of our clients working with us remotely, which means no meetings. So with COVID, that bumped up to over 85%. But it was already part of our workflow to be able to deal with clients completely electronically. At that point, it really doesn't matter where your employees are or really where your clients are. You're still able to be productive, and it really did not slow us down efficiency-wise, I think, at all. If anything, it probably made us more focused and efficient.
And how did that affect your recruiting?
Recruiting-wise is a little bit difficult because most of the things that we want to do to find employees involve at some point meeting with them. So I think it's pretty much put a damper on our ability to do that. And it was a little bit weird this year anyway. So we're really now just starting to get back into recruiting mode at this point for next tax season. So I'm optimistic that hopefully we'll find some people lying around who feel neglected and would like to work for a firm like ours.
Well, that's cool. So finally, obviously there's been this huge shift in how everybody's doing everything. And it sounds like from what you're talking about, you know, recruiting is really deeply affected. You know, do you see that going back to normal, staying the same, being something, I mean, totally different? Where do you expect this to go in 12 months?
I think it's difficult to say. In 12 months, I hope it goes back to the way it was, but I really don't think it's ever going to entirely go back to the way it was. Mm-hmm. I think we're going to be a lot more reliant on doing interviews remotely with Zoom, GoToMeeting, you know, Teams, whatever tool you want to use. I think that's going to become the norm. It's already sort of become the norm for networking group meetings. It's become the norm for client meetings. And I expect that's going to continue. We're just going to have to find some new ways. Obviously, the protocols you use when you interview somebody in person, you can see a lot more things, nonverbal signals and things, than you necessarily get in a Zoom meeting. But we're going to have to adapt and figure it out.
Yeah. Do you, have you used like advertising for your ads much?
We've used the different channels. Indeed is one of the channels we've used a lot with some success. As I mentioned earlier, you really have to do a multi-channel and just be open to people however you can find them. And we were having a discussion about this in our staff meeting this morning. And we're all just sort of brainstorming about who do we know, what do we have access to that we can go out and find some people in some specific areas. For instance, we'd love to have a tax resolution person full time. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to go out and start finding them. And I'm starting to fish on Facebook. That's one of the ponds I'm fishing in because there's a tax resolution group that I joined, as did my partners. And I think we're going to be looking around for some local people to see if they're interested in being part of a larger firm.
Interesting. So it sounds like a good piece of advice might be to kind of look out there on Facebook and Facebook groups and see kind of what's going on in your area.
Yeah, I think that's there's so many accounting Facebook groups out there now. It's worth being involved in a half dozen of them.
Okay, great. Well, Frank, thanks so much for your time this morning. And I hope people learn a lot from our discussion.
Thanks, Richard.
All righty. Take care.